Hey again, everybody, and welcome back. In the previous video, we took a quick look at Persona inside Unreal Engine 4. In this video, we're actually going to go through the process of setting up the inputs that we will need for our character to be able to control them. So essentially the jump and move forward and turning, etc. We're going to set those up right now because those are relatively easy to do inside Unreal Engine 4. So continuing, I have Persona still up here. I'm actually going to close that by clicking this plus sign here. And I'm going to go over to the Edit button here and go down to Project Settings. This is where you can set up the input for your character. So down under the Engine section, about halfway down, there's an Input option. Go ahead and select that. And now we have a bunch of different options in here. The only two that we are really going to worry about for this video series are the bindings. So if you played any PC games out there, essentially key bindings, that's what you are setting up here. You are defining what keys represent what actions in your game. So let's go ahead and set those up. We're going to start with the axis mappings here first. So let's go ahead and click the plus sign here next to axis mappings. And it's created one, but we're going to have to expand it to actually see it. It's giving us a default name here. Yours may be different than mine. We're actually going to rename it anyway. So I'm going to call this first one that we created Move Forward. And this is going to be for controlling our character's forward and backwards movement. So I pressed Enter, and it's created a binding for us. We're actually going to need quite a few more than just this one. So we can click this plus sign here. We're actually going to need four more, so go ahead and click it four more times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And now let's actually define what those bindings are that will cause us to move forward. So on this first one here, I'm going to click the drop down here for none and press W to search for the W keyboard event. We're going to use the traditional W, A, S, and D movement here. So W and S will essentially move us forward and backwards. So let's actually set up S next here. So let's click the drop down on the second one here. And let's search for S and scroll down, find the keyboard section and the S option there. Now we're using W and S to move forward and backwards, and we've named our event here Move Forward, but we actually want S to move us backwards. So it's pretty easy to actually do that because W and S moving forward is going to happen on the same axis. We want to move the opposite direction of S, so we're actually going to go to the scale value here and just change that to a -1 value, like so. So that'll give us the opposite direction movement. So for the rest of these bindings here, we're gonna set this one to, let's say, up, the up keyboard arrow, just in case you wanna use the up arrows. For this one, we'll set the down arrow. So search for down, keyboard down. And again, just like with the S, we need to make this a negative value. So let's set that to -1.0. And then finally, if you're going to play your character with a gamepad, let's actually set up the controls for that. So I'm actually going to expand gamepad here. And we're going to use the gamepad Y axis. So the second one here, the left thumbstick, that's typically what you use for movement. If you're using like a PS4 or Xbox One controller, it's usually the left stick that controls your movement. So let's go ahead and set the left Y axis here. And it's going to be a direct one-to-one, so we don't need to change any scale value here. So let's add another axis mapping here. This is going to be for the lateral movement. So let's actually call this Move Right. And it's created a binding for us. Let's add two more, actually. So let's add two more. If you accidentally click too many, you can just click the plus sign to kill one if you want. So let's add the A and D movement here. So the first one's going to be A. Search for A. Scroll down, keyboard event, and find A. And then let's also add the D while we're at it. So we'll search for D. Scroll down and find that. Now, typically, moving right is done with the D key, and moving left is done with the A key. So our A value is actually going to be the negative value here. So set that to -1, like so. And then we're also going to need the gamepad left X axis. So let's go down and select gamepad. left X axis. So we have our X and Y movement on our left axis, our left thumbstick, and we have W, A, S, and D movement, and up and down movements as well. Notice that we didn't use the left arrow and right arrow. We're actually going to save that for turning as a separate axis, so let's actually set that up right now, actually. So let's click the plus sign. We're going to call this one, actually, turn rate, like so. And let's add two more mappings to this as well. So for this first one, we're going to call this one the gamepad right X axis. So this is the right thumbstick that we're using. And then let's also add the left keyboard arrow and the right keyboard arrow. And for turning left, we're going to set that to negative 1. So turning right will be the right arrow, and turning left will be the left arrow. Makes sense? Let's continue. A couple more that we need to add. So I click the plus sign, and let's rename this one to turn. This is going to be for our mouse control. So for this, we're going to, let's click the drop down and call this mouse X. So the X axis for turning. And let's click the plus sign again. And rename this one to, let's call this look up rate. Now we're calling this look up rate. We want to be able to modify anything with rate here. These are going to be driven by a value, whereas the other ones are going to be one-to-one. One-to-one correlation between the amount of movement, etc. So let's call this lookup rate, and for now we're going to use the gamepad Y axis for this. I can spell sometimes. Gamepad Y axis. Not the left one, make sure you get the right one. So the gamepad right thumbstick Y axis. And then we need one more axis mapping. This is going to be called lookup. And this is going to be our mouse Y. So mouse Y. Now, one thing to mention, you can come back to this later as well. This setting, the mouse Y, is your up and down movement. So if you like inverted controls, so moving up on the mouse like so would actually cause the camera to tilt downwards, you would leave this at 1. However, if you move up and you want the camera to move up with you as well, you would set this to negative 1. So for me, I'm going to set this to 1. You could set that to 1 if you'd like. Or you can remember that inside the project settings under input and the lookup option, this is where you can change that value. We may actually, as we get into this video series a little bit later, set up a property where you can kind of define that in the editor and change it on the fly rather than coming into project settings. But for now, I'm going to set that to negative 1. Okay, one more thing we need to do before we wrap up this video. We're about 8 minutes in, 8.5 minutes in. Let's set up our action mappings. So this is going to be, there's only going to be 2 for this. So let's actually click the plus sign. And the first one that we're going to use is a jump. So our character can jump. And let's expand that. And for this, we're going to use the space bar for this. Now, there's a couple other things here you could do. You could click these checkboxes to say, does shift have to be held when you press space bar to execute jump, etc. We're going to leave those all default. We're not going to mess with those, but just know that they're there. And let's add one more. Let's add one for the gamepad here. So the gamepad, we're going to look for the face buttons, actually. So the triangle, square, X and circle, or YB, X and A, that's what it is? Yeah, that's what it is. We're looking for the bottom one, which is typically the A button or the X button. Let's find the face button bottom. So this will cause our character to jump when that is pressed. And the final action mapping that we're going to add for the purposes of this video series is a punch. So let's call this punch, actually. And let's add for the action mapping, let's call this the left mouse button. So search for left mouse. So holding down the left mouse button will cause us to punch. Let's add one more. Let's say that gamepad face button, the left face button. So if you're looking at a face button controller, so the bottom one, the one directly up to the left of that is going to be our punch. So with all of that, we are done. We are 10 minutes in. We're going to stop here. We have set up all of our input mappings for action and access mappings. We'll run through them really, really quickly. So we've set up jump. We've set up punch. So jump is spacebar and the face button, bottom face button, left mouse button for punch, and the bottom left face button for punch on a gamepad. Moving forward, we have W and S up and down, with down and S set to the negative values. We've also got the gamepad left thumbstick, the Y axis that we can use to move our character. Then we have move right, which is set to A and D, with A being the negative value, and the gamepad left thumbstick X axis for moving right. The turn rate we have set to the gamepad right thumbstick X axis. That is a mouthful. Then we also have the left and right arrows on our keyboard, and left is set to negative as well. Then we have turn, which is going to be controlled by mouse X, and lookup rate, which is controlled by the gamepad right thumbstick Y axis, and lookup is set to mouse Y. Again, we've set this to -1, but you can set this to 1 if you want to invert your controls. So let's pause here. In the next video, we are going to set up the material for our character, just to give them a little bit different of a look. And that's going to do it for this video. We hope to see you in the next video.